where you live.
Knowing I'm on the street where you live.
Frank Sinatra?
And oh,
Julius LaRose, I think.
Is that comfy?
That's just you know, you are near.
And here we have
the Volcano Brothers. There they go, on camera.
Bob and John Hart.
Never before photographed.
Say hello, Bobby.
Come on. Leave me alone.
Come on. Okay. Say hello, Bobby.
Moving around? Okay, good. I have Austin Walk.
Can you move your boots around? We're just taking close-up shots now for inserts later.
Sure.
So we can get a little action with the shoes.
Want some action with your boots?
Whatever, yeah.
I hope they're going to have to slow down the camera.
Those boots either.
Fine.
See, also the way people sound like it's just
I wish the heat guy would get heat in here.
Yeah, everything.
Mm. 2 out of 3 isn't bad.
Hey, I got the building one.
Just clip it to his nipple.
Nip it to his clipboard.
Good it is.
Comedy.
Wonder what
is
the reaction of Ed Sullivan would have been if he was around to put you on.
Hey, look. I'm gonna have to talk to you.
He was.
I love her. Okay. That's fine, yeah.
Okay, and today on the show for the adults we have the Marquee Chicks. And for the kids we have the Beatles.
Strange man.
Well, she would have been hit in the head as he had.
You've been up early this morning, huh?
I know it.
Don't do that when I'm talking either. Don't do that. Do this.
Don't do this, do that. Dun, dun.
You're alive. So come on in.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
Hi, Mom.
Say hello to Uncle George.
And I mean, to stop me a few.
Just for a second, I just want to
Well,
get in.
It doesn't have to be there.
No, keep going.
We've got a lot.
But I mean, they don't shoot you, so just leave.
Zim, 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 zim.
It's up to you.
Yeah, I'm working on it. I have to move the camera to get a close-up.
You need to move the camera.
Want some boots or faces?
They wanted a close-up of that famous
appendage.
Tongue?
You want slow motion, fast motion, side? What do you got?
Do it all. We got about 30 seconds to kill.
Ultraviolet. Merv Griffin had that. You ever hear Ultraviolet? You know her?
Sure.
Yeah.
Merv Griffin had her on the show once. And he said, I hear you have a long tongue. And she took her tongue out and hit her eyebrows with it.
Wow. No, I'm kidding. Who was this?
Everybody went crazy. You were there. You see?
Who's this?
Is she
attractive?
Yeah,
Ultraviolet.
Yeah, she's beautiful.
Oh, yeah? Really?
And you gotta have a record. You
boy, you and her.
Well, she stuck her tongue out and went out and went up and hit. Everybody was crazy.
It went out for lunch.
Maybe we
went to the Carnegie Deli.
I had to chase it all over the theater.
We got a lot. Dun, dun, dun.
No, I got it. Beautiful.
I have often walked down the street. Oh. But the pavement never fell.
I love that song. Zama, 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 zama.
Oh, welcome to our living room. We're here relaxing this afternoon. We're waiting for tea. All the afternoon soaps are off. Nothing to do.
They're truly poor.
Have you met my butler, Simmons?
Simmons, be good.
And then, remember, look.
You rang.
You rang.
I have also
Guys on the ends, you had to lean in.
Lean on us.
Just, you know, it's a general thing during the interview. Just,
right, okay.
You know, beware of just not be leaning aware. Out.
Should we all lean in, lean back? What do
no,
you
guys are okay.
No, you're fine.
Fine.
Anytime, Al.
Okay. Welcome to the show. We're talking with Kiss.
Here we are.
Yes, hello.
Hi, folks.
Hello, hello.
Hello, hello America.
We just come from Montreal. That's why we talk like this.
Welcome to Nightflight. My name is Al Bandiero, and my guests are Kiss.
Hello, Al.
Hello, Al.
How are you?
Fine.
I'm fine.
Thank How's you for coming to Nightflight.
America, hi.
Why don't you introduce yourself? We'll go from left to right.
Vinnie Vincent.
Stevie Nicks. Paul Stanley.
Gene Simmons.
Right in back of Paul's hand.
Eric Carr. Yeah, no, they just...
Okay, and the outside gentlemen are the two newest members in the group.
Hey.
If we can...
Let's do the second intro again. And let's just do it a little bit slower.
Okay,
I was going to say Eddie Carter.
Okay, you'll be sorry.
I know.
Okay.
All right. Welcome to Nightflight. My name is Al Bandiero, and we're talking with... Kiss. Welcome, gentlemen.
Hi.
Hi.
Hi, Al. How are you?
Hey, Al!
All right.
How are you?
How about if we introduce from left to right?
Vinnie Vincent.
Stevie Nicks. Paul Stanley.
Gene Simmons.
Eric Carr.
Okay, now this group has sold over 50 million records, recorded 17 albums. So far, so good?
So far, so good.
Okay. I like it.
15 gold, 11 like platinum.
We lose count after 10.
Okay, and then history has been made with Kiss as far as music is concerned. Can we get into the previous band before Kiss to bring it up to date?
Sure.
So all people do is see what you're at now, where you're at. They think it's an overnight success. Let's go back to the days when you were paying some dues.
Well, Gene and I were in a band in 71, 72. And we wanted to do a big theatrical presentation, but most of the guys in the band, we kind of looked like we were at a bus stop waiting for the bus. There was tall guys and short guys and hairy guys and bald guys. Nothing against bald people. We're all headed that way. But we just decided we want to put together something really spectacular. And I guess we had a record deal, and once we finished the album, we fired the band and went looking for new members. And we saw a ad in the paper that said drummer willing to do anything.
That was in Brooklyn, right?
That's right. And the drummer willing to do anything was Peter Criss. And we went to see him, and he was willing to do anything.
He was playing in the King's Lounge in Brooklyn.
In Brooklyn. Well, you and I are from the same neighborhood, Gene.
Williamsburg. Yeah.
And
except you used to chase me. I used to run when I was little. Now it's my turn.
Now, you're from?
I'm from Manhattan, all the way uptown, Inwood. Some people don't know about Inwood. It's like right before Riverdale, 211th right. Street Broadway.
You know, some people with Inwood know about it.
Moving right along.
It's like Outwood, only backwards.
And the two new members.
I'm actually from Connecticut, born in Connecticut. Bridgeport, Connecticut.
Yeah, but Vinny's heart lies in Brooklyn. He can't be Italian and talk like this and not
my heart lies
and come from Connecticut.
Brooklyn, eh?
Eric
got one in Brooklyn.
Yeah, I'm a Brooklyn guy. I was born in Brooklyn, raised in Brooklyn, East New York, which, as you may know, is a very tough neighborhood. That's why I'm so tough.
Backtrack a little bit. Where was the very, very first show that you put on?
First show we put
on in our living rooms when we were little kids for our parents and our uncles.
Right.
Right.
I used to, go next door and lip sync, you know, mimic records.
Professionally.
Professionally. We did a show at a place in Queens called Coventry. It was on Queens Boulevard. We didn't want to get lumped in with all the New York bands, all the glitter bands, so we went looking for our own club. So our first show was for the bartender in a bar. Nobody else showed up.
With the makeup?
Yeah, Kiss has always looked just like, I mean, Kiss
from day
from
one.
Day
that
one.
You put together.
Yeah. I mean, basically, there's tapes of us playing a club on Long Island, and we were doing all the songs that were on the first and second album. That's never really changed.
The very first reaction to where people started coming in droves, so to speak, to see what you were all about, what was that kind of reaction?
I remember getting up on stage in Long Island. This was in Amityville. I suppose a couple blocks from where that ghost house was. And people are drinking. I remember just putting our guitars down in one of the sections of the song and running out into the audience and making people put their drinks down and forcing them to clap their hands. Once, there was a pregnant girl in the front of the little club, and I sat on her lap, and she wasn't quite there, apparently she'd had. Anyway, it wasn't a nice thing to do. I think the baby's okay now, but there was a point there. And, you know, when we first walked in, the security guy there, the big guy, was going to knock us out. We were really scared. And we'd lock ourselves in the dressing room, putting on our makeup, and we'd be answering the phone. People would call up and say, well, who's playing there tonight? We'd say, oh, the best band you ever saw, Kiss. They wear makeup. They do all kinds of strange things. You'll love them.
They hide from the bouncer. They hide from the bouncer.
And the club owner had no idea what we were doing. We refused to do any Rolling Stones or cover songs or anything. And he complained the first weekend. Second weekend, it sold out. And
he really used to get pissed because a bar does its business on liquor. And we were so loud that they couldn't hear anybody ordering drinks. But what happened over a period of a week or two is we were doing such a big business at the door that they didn't care. And it didn't really matter.
As long as the people
bouncer
came in.
Bouncer would be so anxious for the show that he'd come and knock on the door. Come on out, you guys. Come on out now, you know. And that sounds like John. We've got a security guy. His name is John Hart. Sounds just like that.
There's an interesting story about how you got the record companies to come and see you. The story along with the Bratz. Tell our viewers about that. That's interesting.
We would rent our own concert hall. This was at the Diplomat Hotel, 43rd and 6th. Still there, I think. They haven't torn it down yet.
Home of reasonably
still there.
Yeah, home of reasonably priced prostitutes.
And we put on our own concert. We rented the hall, took the ads out in the newspaper, and actually had little contracts with the opening acts. But we were the opening act. The Bratz at that point were a more popular bass band. And we invited everybody to come, you know, the record industry to come and see us. And we'd say in the invitation, complimentary ticket, showtime, 9:30. And of course, you know, they'd come and see us, and by the time we were off, they'd leave. And the headline act, the Bratz, would come on at 11 o'clock, and by that time...
Did they know that this was going on,
no.
The Bratz?
No. Certainly not.
I think...
Sorry, guys.
Yeah, probably what set us apart from a lot of the other bands is that we were kind of thinking along those kind of lines. It wasn't really enough to just get out and play.
No, we were serious about this. We wanted this to happen.
So you were going to pull out all the stops to...
That's right.
...to do something. If we can, once Kiss has been successful, let's get into some negatives that I know you came across. How did you deal with them as far as the parents were concerned? Because I'm sure when they saw their children bring home an album and say, what is that?
We never... I guess...
Did you have any confrontations with parents?
Or, I think we kind of took it as a compliment because we never really wanted to appeal to parents. I mean, trouble with a lot of parents is they forget they were ever young. And we were never trying to be a critics band, and we were never trying to be a, you know, the band that the parents approved of, because that's not what rock and roll is all about. Rock and roll is sex and freedom, three things that a lot of adults fear, I guess.
That in the beginning, though, it is true that we would go out and open up for acts from all the way from Savoy Brown to Manfred Mann, acts that were sort of on their last legs anyway, and we'd catch a lot of flack from, you know, Roberta would call up and say, we get flack, you get it? But it wouldn't matter because even before our record came out, we would tour with these acts, and we'd have our logo on the stage and amps bigger than the headline act, and even once we went off the stage, our logo would be hanging above you know, the stage. This was before anybody ever really started to do that sort of stuff. It wasn't considered in vogue to hang a sort of a Las Vegas sign above the band. It was a little too garish, but we didn't care about that stuff. We wanted to make an impression, and the logo would flash so bright that even when the other act was on, you'd still see Kiss in front of your eyes. We wanted them.